Hi, I'm Bill Snodgrass. Welcome to this tutorial on the PortraitPro 18. So we're going to do a quick start guide just to kind of, if you are new to PortraitPro and you want to get in and get going. So I'm going to try to do a quick start guide, something that will let you get some of the fundamentals down and be ready to go. So I've already opened a photograph in Photoshop. Obviously, everything is installed. This is an associate photographer with my Bill Snodgrass photography. This is Emma Carrillo, and she's a really talented photographer, but she also agreed to let me edit this picture for the tutorial. I've already gone through the camera raw filter. A lot of times we'll start with the camera raw filter just to kind of get the color depth and the contrast and things situated. And now I'm ready to launch the plugin. So we'll go to the plugins and under filter, hit Portrait Pro. The first thing Portrait Pro is gonna try to do is identify faces in the picture. Once it has identified faces, it's going to try to put control points on various parts of the face. In Portrait Pro 18, what I have encountered so far is it does a really good job of doing that in the pictures that I have attempted to use. So it wants to know, is it male, female, or child? This is female. And it is going to add the default to it. And all of these are on, all these buttons are on except for the hair. It is done a pretty good job. I do tend to try to get the control points a little tighter. And using the mouse wheel, I can scroll in and move these around. This is probably, in my opinion, the step that you need to spend the most time on getting started. And that is getting all of these control points in the right place. So just to go ahead and get started, I'm gonna grab this eyebrow and try to straighten this out and try to make it fit her eyebrow a little bit better. And moving the control points around will allow me to do that. This is gonna kind of be the arch. Where is the apex in the arch? And then trying to get these in. Now the software is smart enough that it tries to reflect what I've done on this side across to the other side. Because of the angle that her face is, it is missed a little bit. And I want to get that line down just a little bit and bring that corner in just a little bit more. Zooming in on the eyes, there is the iris, and then there is the lens, or the colored part of the eye and the black part of the eye. You want this dot to be in the center of the eye, and then you want this ring to encompass the colored part of the eye, and then the green ring is going to encompass the black part of the eye. Putting these control points in the corners of the eye and trying to not get so much of the eyelid into the control points, and then I'm going to scroll across. If you click on the after view, you can drag the image around, and if you click on the before view, you're in the part where you're moving the control points. That looks pretty much like the eyeball to me. And we have everything seems to be in the right place there. And this is one of the things I feel like they have improved between version 17 and version 18. Drag this up. I want to grab this one and move it in just a little bit tighter to the nose. And the reason we're doing this, the reason we're trying to get all these things set in the right place, is the lighting, the shadowing, and the enhancements are all based on these control points. And it will try to mirror, assuming that the face is symmetric, it will try to mirror across the central axis to get those control points all in the right place. As an example of what happens if the control points are not in the right place, I can drag this one into the wrong place, and you can begin to see that it is trying to make an alteration that we don't want. And when I let go, it'll straighten that out somewhat, but we know that there's something wrong in that area. Likewise, if I go too high, it will begin to try to apply skin to the face that's up there. So it's going to try to apply skin to the hair, which we don't want that to happen. So we want to put that right on the hairline. And then zoom out just a little bit. Once I have all my control points set, then I'm ready to start using all of the various different pieces of the software. Each one of these deserves a tutorial of its own, and I'm only going to very quickly go through and just toggle them on and off using the default preset. Turning the sculpting off is going to change the features of the face back to the original. What it tries to do is, using all of these different internal settings, it tries to take into account the camera, the lens, any kind of things like that, and modify the shape of the face into the Portrait Pro ideal. So that's what's going on with sculpting. This is something I recommend using very, very sparingly. And if you go in and look at all of the different settings, you can see that a lot of those things are very much variable. Skin smoothing, this is going to deal with colors under the eyes, blemishes, pimples, wrinkles, all those kinds of things. Skin smoothing, the lighting and coloring is perhaps one of the most profound changes. When you turn lighting coloring on, it's going to maximize and idealize and optimize all of the lighting, and there's also skin coloring settings down as well, where you can change the texture of the skin, and there are various different settings. The lighting has a modeling lighting and a fixed light, and these two settings will do drastic changes. You can also move the light around to where it's supposed to be. I know in this picture that the room light was here. It was dark outside, so I could use the lighting to kind of even that out or even more enhance the contrast. So you can move the light around, turning it on and turning it off using the toggle. The makeup section, my stepdaughter once told me, don't mess with the girl's makeup unless you know what you're doing. So I tend to be very careful with this and not do a whole lot with it. One of the things I do from time to time is I will do a mascara, which is not really a mascara, and I will do false eyelashes just because sometimes it seems like it would be a fun thing to do. And it depends on what I'm going to do with the picture. If I'm delivering this back to the model or the model's family, then I may not do that. If I'm just playing around with something for Instagram, I might add some false eyelashes just for fun. So the makeup, if you can spend literally as much time as you want adjusting the different things. Eyeliner, blusher, bronzer, highlighter, eyebrow pencil. That is another that I will sometimes do just to kind of smooth out what's going on in the eyebrows. But for the most part, I don't do a whole lot in there. Eye enhancement is something I do a lot with, and you can just apply it to one or the other eye, and then you have options for left eye and right eye on everything. I do like to sharpen the eyes and add maybe sometimes brightening them or whitening them. So eyes, mouth, and nose, I don't use this a whole lot. You can turn it on and turn it off. It's very subtle. One thing you can do is pull the lips out a little bit more. Hair is, this is highly improved between 17 and 18. In this version, the hair recoloring, it seems to have gotten a lot smarter, and you can very quickly, you can do some very dramatic changes to the hair coloring. You can go blacker or whatever you want to do. There's a lot that you can be played with in there. Picture, this is general overall settings of the photograph exposure, all the things that you would expect. This is general overall color, temperature, tint, all those things. You can turn that on and off. And then the one of the 17 upgrades was the layering, and I briefly have worked with this. Doing the background mask, it seems to have gotten much better at masking out the background. I will do more on that and talk about it. So that's your quick start guide. That is what this is very, very powerful. You can just literally go through the presets and change it until you find one you like, and never mess with any of the actual controls, but just dealing with the presets alone, you can quickly enhance the picture in a lot of different ways. So that is your quick start guide. Get the control point set, and then you begin working with the controls or working with the presets, or get a preset that you like, and then go from there into the controls and make changes. I've been using this for a year and a half, 2 years now. Almost every portrait that I deliver to a client goes through this. If not this, I have another plugin I use. But this is fast becoming my go-to for individuals. You can also do groups in here. You go through the process twice, and there is enhance another face in this photo. So it'll go and find the second face, and you can apply all of the same process to one or more people in the picture. That's it. I hope you enjoyed this. I try to be quick, try to get through everything quickly. It is a very powerful, very, very powerful plugin. And when you're done, you just go return from plugin. It takes all your changes back into whatever layer you were working on in Photoshop. If you enjoyed this, please click the like button, subscribe to the channel, and sign up for notifications. Mostly in my channel, I do motivation, inspiration videos, and those kinds of things. I also do the occasional photography tutorial. I'm going to do more of those now that this plugin is out. I'll go through each of the different settings, so if you want to stay in tune on that. And I am a full-time science teacher, so I do science videos as well. If you found your way here through YouTube search, that's pretty much what this channel is about. Day in the life, inspirational, motivational videos, kind of life lessons, and then the occasional science video, and the photography videography tutorials. That's all I got for this one. We'll see you in the next episode.